All right, here we go. Adjustments. This is one of the trickier things to accounting that some students have problems with, because typically when we do anything in accounting that especially deals with cash, we journalize it at that time. If we pay for something, we do a journal entry right then. If we receive cash, we do a journal entry right then. But adjustments are a little different, because adjustments are things that I can postpone doing the journal entry for, or maybe doing a whole bunch of journal entries for, until the very end of the year and just do one giant journal entry at the very end. So let's start talking about adjustments. Adjustments are journal entries that are made at the end of the period. So again, if you're dealing with a normal calendar year, you're dealing with December 31st. They happen on December 31st. That reflect transactions or events that have not yet been recorded. There are some things that happen monthly. And instead of doing one each month, you just do one at the very end because cash hasn't been affected yet. Or again, you don't know about it until the very end. You're going to do a journal entry because cash isn't affected yet. You're going to see some of these examples in the next videos. This affects one or more income statement account and one or more balance sheet account. So if you were to write down the letters on your sheet of paper, write in capital letters the word real, R-E-A-L, and then split that word right down the middle, that is a good representation of how adjustments work. Because one side of the equation, whether it be debit or credit, it doesn't matter, but one side of it is going to be revenue or expense, that's the R and the E, and then the other side of the equation is going to be assets or liabilities. You won't have any equity in this. This is just, you won't have two assets in this. It'll be one is going to be revenue expenses. The other one is going to be assets or liability. That's a good way to just make sure you're on the right path. Four different types of adjusting entries. There are four different things, and these are the next four videos really that we're going to be talking about. Deferred expenses. These are deferred. We're going to push these expenses into the very end. Deferred revenues. You're going to push these revenues to the very end. Accrued expenses. These are things that we've amassed or saved up as expenses, and we're going to do that at the very end. And then we also have accrued revenue. So we're going to do examples of each. Please, if you haven't watched Chapter 2's example video, you're going to want to do that, because the examples that we're going to be doing are going to fall right in line with that. So you're going to want to make sure you have those, or these are not going to make any sense. So, but that's adjustments.